So one of the things we're working on right now is looking at how specific climate patterns affect avalanche cycles in a given season. So we're using tree rings. So as an avalanche hits a tree, it creates a scar on the tree. And when we look at the rings on the tree, we can actually see that scar and date it to a specific year. And that allows us to create avalanche activity chronologies where we don't have observations. So when we're out in the field, we're looking for dead and down trees that ideally would exhibit some sort of avalanche scar. So this right here, we suspect could be an avalanche scar. But what we'd do is then we'd cut into this dead and down tree and then take a thin cross section from this tree. And then we can take that to the lab, process it by sanding it, looking at it under the microscope, counting all the rings, and then cross dating it. We're trying to associate any climate patterns, things like El Nino or La Nina or other indices like that, storminess, whether it was a big winter in terms of snow accumulation. So we're trying to look at those relationships between climate and big avalanche years. This will allow us to sort of understand, by studying the past, allow us to understand how the future might be affected by a changing climate.